Welcome back to my little channel. Today I'm going to do something slightly different. For this I have a blood oxygen meter, a handkerchief, don't worry, it's clean, a cheap splatter shield, and a rather more cheaper splatter shield. And I mean, we have been told that wearing masks is a problem because CO2. Yeah, not really. CO2 isn't a real issue. I mean, yes, sure, if you have too much CO2, it becomes an issue, but the issue is far more direct. And I'm going to put my medication aside. It's just here for the just in case, because we are told to wear a mask because of COVID-19, and we do so to protect the weak and the vulnerable. And unfortunately, I am one of those weak and vulnerable people. And I'll show you what that means. You should be able to see it. A blood oxygen meter. You will see my heart rate and my oxygen level. My heart rate is a bit high at the moment, but it'll get lower. Don't worry. I've been walking around a bit. And you see that my blood oxygen saturation is about 97%. It's a little bit low. It should be a little bit higher, I've been told. But it's pretty much the highest it will be with me. I don't get a good oxygen saturation in my blood. Not that strange, because my lungs aren't that great. Okay, so what? Well, we're supposed to wear a mask. And to pretend that I have a mask, I'm going to use this handkerchief. And it's a normal thin handkerchief. So if you have a mask made out of this, you just know it won't do any good. And yes, the handkerchief is clean. And I'm going to hold it in front of my mouth and I'm going to breathe through it. Now, I'm going to hold it pretty tight against my mouth, which is not too tight, obviously, which is not really fair, because if you have a mask, the distance, well, the chamber between the mask and your mouth becomes a little bit bigger. And yes, sure, that could be more CO2 in there. But let's be honest, you're going to take liters of air. And that little bit of air, yeah, it will not be perfect. But there's another issue with it. And I'm going to do it right now. Oh, by the way, if I do some editing in the video, it's not because the result didn't come the way I wanted. It's because sometimes we have to wait a little bit for a result. And between each test, I'm going to try to get my blood oxygen measurement back to 97%. So, yeah, that's a pre-warning. This part so far has not been edited. Has not been edited. Hey, look at that. My blood oxygen already went down to 96, and I'm not even wearing the mask yet. Well, let's give it a little bit of... I've been talking a lot, that's probably why. Now, people will tell you 96 isn't really a problem, and they'd be right. 97 isn't really a problem either. But it's a little bit on the low side, which doesn't mean makes any sense, but I'm not a doctor as such, so I don't really understand how it works. I do, however, know that once you reach 94, it is considered a problem. We're back to 97. Let's put the mask on. No, first I'm going to cough. Okay, not corona, by the way. Here we go, putting the mask on. Now, I'm already breathing in the mask. And it went down a little bit. Could be because of the coughing, let's be honest. Let's not... Yeah, it's probably because of the coughing, because it went back to 97. Okay. Now I'm going to breathe easily with the mask on. Okay, it's been on 95 for a few seconds now. I'm putting it down, but you can see it's fluctuating between 97 and 95, and that's only in this short period of time. I'm going to cut the video for a moment, not the sound, because the sound can go on. I'm going to cut the video so that I'll try to put the video back once I am at 97 again, because my body needs to recuperate from losing. It's coming back, it's already going back. This was, by the way, only one layer of a handkerchief. This isn't wool, this is a thin handkerchief. It's, yeah. So what will happen when I start wearing the splatter mask? And I'll start with the cheapest of the two. And by the way, this is only after a few seconds. This hasn't been, I'm wearing this all day. So who knows what would happen if I would wear it all day. Well, I know, but, and no, I wouldn't die. I'm not going to say that. But it does tire one out. It really does. If I wear it for half an hour, I'm fucked. If I wear it for 5 minutes, I'm pretty much destroyed for the rest of the day. Anyway, I'm going to wait to bring it back to 97, but you can see the top is closed once I put it on. We're back at 97. Oh. I need two hands to put it on. And yeah, it's put on. And yeah, it drops to 96, as you notice, pretty fast. And the downside of the cheap splatter shield is, oh, 95 already. The downside of the cheap splatter shield, 94, is that the inside of the splatter shield is condensing because of my breathing. Now, 94 is pretty low. Now, people will tell you that sometimes when you hit 94, you get told to go to the doctor, etc., etc., etc. Yeah, not a bad idea, but unfortunately it happens to me quite often, but not when I'm sitting still like this. And I am already noticing that I'm getting a little bit of a headache. Not because of CO2, as some people might suggest, but because a lack of oxygen. It's not a huge lack. I won't lose consciousness or anything like that, but it is rather annoying. You will see that it's jumping between 95 and 94. I think I've shown enough. I've only put it on like several seconds. We're not talking about minutes. We're not talking about hours. And it's already having this effect on me. I'm going to take it off and we're going to wait till my blood oxygen is decent again so I can start using the slightly less expensive splatter mask. And we are back at 97 again for a while, and I'm trying to put the bloody thing on one-handed, and it's on one-handed. Now, as I said a moment ago, it's taking longer between tests for me to get back to 97. I don't know why it is, or rather, I think I know why it is, because my body doesn't respond that well to my lungs. But yeah, I've got the slightly more expensive splatter shield, and one of the great things about it is that it doesn't condensate on the inside. So even after I talk, I can still see what I'm looking at. But you see, it's already dropping to 96. It's not dropping as fast as it was with the other splatter shield. It's dropping slightly at the rate that the handkerchief was. Oh, it's at 95, so it's also faster than the handkerchief. But the handkerchief is thinner than the thinnest mouth mask you can buy. Yeah, 95 is somewhat of a problem. And I'm going to keep it on. Oh, 94 already. It goes fast, doesn't it? This is, again, don't worry about my health. I'm not feeling sick. I don't have the feeling that I'm going to die anytime soon. But it's not good. And this is the problem you can have, when wearing something in front of your respiratory system to prevent you from getting a disease. Funny enough, the disease is a virus, and yeah, even with the handkerchief, the disease would simply go through. Never mind that. And don't forget, people, you're asked to wear a mask to protect people like me, which is all good and fun, but people like me shouldn't be wearing a mask to begin with. Yeah, time to take my meds. And 94 still, that is several seconds after I took off the splatter shield. I don't know how fast the blood oxygen thing will go up now, but it's already going up. But then again, it's been hovering between 95 and 94 for a while. Let's see if it'll go up to 96. That would be nice, because I don't want to sit here minutes proving to you that this is an issue. Now, anyone would say, yeah, but that's you, mate, your health is crap. Hey, 96, that's just you, your health is crap. I would say, yeah, you're correct. And this is why I can't wear a face shield or a mask. And I think this is pretty much true for a lot of people out there who now get ignored because wearing a mask is mandatory. Yeah, I'm talking too much. Wow, even with the medication, it takes time for my body to readjust to the lost oxygen. Then again, my lungs are bad. I did know that. Now, mind you, I mean, I'm not telling people that this is a huge issue, or rather it is an issue, but yeah, 94 is low. You can still walk with it. Don't worry. You're not going to die. But can you imagine if that happens only within seconds after starting to wear a mask? What will it do if you wear that mask for a longer time? I'm not going to test that, if you don't mind. Hey, we're back to 97, so my medication kind of helped. I hope you don't mind the editing. Criticism, as always, is more than welcome. Like, share and subscribe if you feel so inclined to. And I hope to see you all next time.